Good morning, brothers and sisters. Who's ready to celebrate the resurrection of our Lord? It's going to be a beautiful day. Beautiful. I just stepped out of the shower. Maybe I should take my... Oh, that's why it's so dark in the shower. I should have took my glasses off. So it's going to be a beautiful day. And so we have a great service. A lot of people contributed in different ways. You'll see that. And it's going to be a wonderful day here. We hope that... That you and your family and loved ones can call each other and get in touch. Various ways to do that. And kids, if you're watching this at home with mom and dad, you do have my permission to jump onto bed today. So right in the beginning of the service, there is a children's sermon. There's a woman who's, warning here, there's a woman who's gonna come on the screen shortly. Don't be afraid of her, right? Don't be afraid. Okay, so. It's going to be a great day. And yeah, so we're going to get going here and begin in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Go LA, we love you.
Well, hello, y'all. Welcome, kids, to the children's message. Do you know who I am? I know you've seen me at church. I know I look a little different right now, right? So how about if I take off the scarf? Okay, do you guys know who I am now? No? Okay, how about if I remove the hat? Does that help a little bit? How about the glasses? Hey, guys, it's Miss Tracy. Did you know who I was? I looked a little different, didn't I? Well, today's a very special day in our church. Happy Easter. It's Easter. And I know it looks a little different. You're probably used to being at church and now you're at home. And maybe you're used to going out to brunch or having a big supper with your families. And not a lot of people are going to be together today because we're all trying to be at home safe. And even though it looks different, Easter is always going to be Easter because of what Jesus did for us and how very much he loves you. So even though I looked different because I had a costume on, it doesn't change the fact that I'm Miss Tracy. And even though Easter looks different this year, it doesn't change the fact that it's Easter. And Jesus did what he did because he loves you, and it will always be Easter because of that. So before I take you to today's Bible story, let's back up a little bit. Remember on Friday, day before yesterday, Jesus died for us, and he was put on the cross. And when he died, his body was put in the tomb. And not only was his body put in the tomb, but he took all of our sins with him in his death. And he said that if we had him in our hearts, that those sins would be washed away. So in today's Bible story, Mary and Mary went back to the tomb where Jesus had been laid, and they were going to anoint his body with oils. Well, when they got there, they saw an amazing thing. The stone that was covering the tomb had been rolled away, and there was an angel. And they said that the angel was as white as snow and as bright as lightning. Can you imagine seeing something like that? As a matter of fact, it scared the guards so badly, they fainted. And Mary were so in awe. And you know what I love? It's the first thing the angel said to Mary and Mary is, don't be afraid. And I think I love that so much because God loves us so much. He wants to remind us that we don't ever need to be afraid of anything like what's going on in our world right now or of seeing an angel, because everything he does is because he loves us. So we never have to be afraid. And he said, if you're looking for Jesus, he's not here. He did what he promised he was going to do. He rose up into heaven. And so he told Mary and Mary, go tell the disciples what you've seen. Tell them that Jesus rose from the dead like he promised he would, and that Jesus is coming to see them. And we'll talk more about that in later Sundays. But today is so important because we know that Jesus conquered death, and that someday, even if we die or when we die, we don't need to be afraid because we're all going to go to heaven together. That's how much God loves us. He sent Jesus so we could all be with him someday together. And I know when you look around your house, it's fun to see all the spring decorations with bunnies and chicks. As a matter of fact, I have some. I decorate my house with bunnies and chicks to celebrate spring. But this is my favorite decoration. And if you can see it, it says, he is risen. And what we say as Christians today is, he is risen. And when someone says that to you, you respond, he is risen indeed. And you have to say it with a lot of joy because we're so happy about what he did for us. So even though you see decorations with bunnies, this really isn't what Easter's about. This is a great celebration of spring. When we talk about Easter, we talk about how much Jesus loves us and what he did for us. So you guys want to practice together? Let's go. Ready? I'm going to say, he is risen, and you shout, he is risen indeed. I want your whole family to do it with you, and I want you to do it with as much joy and love in your hearts as Jesus has for you. So ready? He is risen. Did you do it loudly? All right. I'm really proud of you. And I'm sorry we can't all be together. I miss you very much, but I know you're happy and I know you're safe and I know you're loved. And most importantly, I know it's Easter. Happy Easter.
That was great, Tracy. Thanks a bunch. So here we are. Let's begin. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Let's have our worship leader take us into the resurrection of our Lord. Over to you, John. Thank you, John. One more time. Hallelujah. Christ has risen. Christ has risen indeed. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Thank you. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, you gave your Son to suffer death on a cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection, through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Let's have our choir director, Ethan Smith, take us into that Easter morning. Awesome. Thank you, Ethan. I love the trumpet. God speaks to us in Scripture today. The first reading comes from Acts chapter 10. If you have your Bibles, you can follow along. Peter began to speak to the people. I truly understand that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, anyone who fears Him and does what is right is acceptable to Him. You know the message He sent to all the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ. He is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and power, went around doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did in both Judea and Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God. The second reading comes from Colossians, the third chapter. If you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things on the earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, is revealed, then you also will be revealed with him in glory. Here ends the reading. Thanks be to God. Let us say the Alleluias together. Alleluia. Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. Alleluia. The gospel for today is written in the 28th chapter of Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. After the Sabbath, on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descending from heaven came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised. As he said, come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshiped him. And Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." This is, my friends, the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. This is a new type of Easter. I'm going to ask my friends Johnny and Elisa to lead us into this new Easter.
Just wanna be with you, King. want to be with you. Yes, the world will bow down and say you are God. Every man will bow down and say you are King. So let's start right now. What would we wait? Praise His name in victory. King of glory, fill this place. Just want to be with you. We just want to be.
Thanks, Johnny and Lisa. I love that song. Always brings tears to my eyes. What a great song. So a quick word for today. One of my favorite scriptures comes out of the time where Jesus is on his way into Jerusalem, just before Palm Sunday. In fact, it was Palm Sunday. He's on his way in. And so they're coming in from Jericho, and the crowd is following them, and Jesus ends up borrowing a donkey and riding in on Palm Sunday, and people start shouting, Hosanna. So on the way into town, this comes out of Matthew 21. It says, as they were leaving Jericho, a large crowd followed him. And two blind men sitting by the road, hearing that Jesus was passing by, cried out, Lord, have mercy on us. That's what I want to talk about today. We call that the Jesus Prayer. And it's said in a couple different places in Scripture and all in different Gospels. And it's the greatest prayer. It is our prayer. Now you may say, well, Pastor Ken, what about the Lord's Prayer? The Lord's Prayer belongs to the church. It was taught to Jesus teaching his disciples, who became the apostles, who became the leaders of the church. Notice the words, our Father, not my Father. Forgive our sins. Forgive our trespasses. It doesn't say forgive my trespasses. So it's a community prayer. It's a prayer we say with others. It's a prayer we say in the church. Of course, you can say it by yourself, but it was made for the church, made for the disciples and the apostles. This prayer was made for us individually. Six words. And because Jesus wasn't yet risen, they didn't use the name Lord. But for us, these six words, Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. Six words. That's the Jesus Prayer. And that's our gift for today. Think about it. Lord. Lord means that Jesus is risen. That's why we call him Lord. He's risen. And so by saying that, we say the whole Bible in one word. Lord. Jesus is risen. Lord. Everything said in that one word. And the next word is Jesus. Remember, Jesus was not the name that Mary chose. She didn't have that option like many of us have. Well, what are you going to call your baby? Oh, we call baby Henry or Sam or Lucy or Martha. Mary didn't have that option. The angel came to her in a dream and said, Mary, you are going to have a son by the Holy Spirit, and you will call his name Jesus. There's no option. Mary obeyed. She could have said, well, can I call him like Sammy Jesus or Henry? No, just Jesus. Just stay with Jesus, right? So Jesus was the name given by the angel to Mary, to us. So when we say his name, we're obedient in the same way that Mary was obedient. Obedient to God in his plan. His name is Jesus. So Lord Jesus. That says a lot. Two words. And then we go to have mercy on us. What does that say? That says we need God in our lives. God, be with me. Have mercy on me. I'm not perfect. I need you to be with me and walk with me every day. Let's see what happens when we say that prayer. Let's carry on. It says, and then they were leaving Jericho. A large crowd followed them, and two blind men sitting on the road. They're hearing Jesus come by. They cried out, Lord, have mercy on us. And the crowd told them, be quiet, be quiet. Don't bug Jesus. He's a busy man. Is that true? Is God too busy for us? Let's find out. But they said it again. They said, Lord, have mercy on us. They were being even louder. And Jesus did what? He says, go away, you guys. I'm too busy. Don't you know I'm going into a parade? And no, he didn't say that. He stopped and said to them, what do you want me to do for you? What a prayer. What a prayer. When we say that prayer, it stops Jesus. It gets his attention. And what does he say to us? What do you want me to do for you? It gets God's attention. What a great prayer. What do you want me to do for you? And they said, Lord, we want our eyes to be open. We're blind. We can't see. And then Jesus, looking at his watch, said, None of that. What did he do? He was moved with compassion. Moved with compassion. When we talk to Jesus, when we pray to him, he's moved with compassion for us. And he touched their eyes, and immediately they regained their sight, and they followed him. Perfect. What a perfect prayer. So that prayer is for us today, to begin using it today. Unlock that prayer today. Take it out of the can and start using it. It's for us today. When do we use it? All day long. When you wake up in the morning, the first thing you want to do is say that prayer. During the day, in the evening, Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. The best prayer. And in fact, it's not a long prayer. It doesn't take a lot of time. In fact, you shouldn't pray this prayer a long time. You don't go off and pray this prayer for hours. 5 minutes or less, that's all. It takes less than 15 seconds to say it. But if you want to say it a couple times, do it. But don't spend more than 5 minutes doing that. It's a short prayer. Spend a few minutes with the Lord saying that prayer. That's all you need to do. And remember that Jesus is listening. We're using his name. And he is our risen Lord and Savior. And I think it's important, because he was telling us that just before he went into Jerusalem. Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. What a great gift. What a great Easter. What a great day this is going to be. You'll remember this forever. Lord Jesus, have mercy on me. It's God's gift to you this Easter. So be blessed in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We need another Hosanna song. Ethan Smith, lead us in a Hosanna.
Hosanna, Hosanna. be thine.
We're getting near the end of our service. I want to say thank you to Ethan and John and Johnny and Lisa and Tracy and Deborah for putting all the bulletins together for us, and for all of you for being our faithful flock, followers of Jesus. In the midst of this time that we're living in, this unprecedented time, I hope we come out better people for it. I hope we've learned something and pumped the brakes for a minute and looked at our lives, and we'll make changes in the future that will greatly benefit ourselves, our family, our community, our church. Let's not be hard-hearted like Pharaoh and resist what the Spirit's doing in our lives. Let's go forward with a new purpose, new courage, and new hope that this resurrection morn gives us. Let us pray. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God all over the world, in all times, in all places, praying for our church and our world and those in need today. God of the resurrection, from the very beginning, you give the church the gift of women, faithful women, as your witnesses, as preachers and teachers and leaders and homemakers and wives and business leaders. Open our ear to listen to them as the first witnesses of the resurrection. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. All of your creation praises you. The earth hums, the seas pulse, the stars shine, the galaxies whirl in glorious harmony to honor you today, Lord. Let us blend our voices in this song. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The countries of our world are experiencing conflict and sorrow and tragedy today. Help us to set our minds on the rule of justice and love. Help us to all build our countries on the cornerstone of your peace and your hope. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Today we weep with those who weep, we mourn with those who mourn. Cradle today the fearful, the suffering, the dying, assuring them of your loving presence. Especially Diddy Van Buten, Jim Thompson family, those on the medical ships, Mercy, for Shaylee's and unborn infant, for Mary and Diane, for the Vandersall family, the Sten family, the Fortune family, Debbie, John, Sharon, Phil, and David. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Bless all the creative and helpful worship leaders today, musicians and ushers and greeters and readers and worship attendants and preachers and all who provide hospitality that makes our church a warm and inviting place. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For all of our fellowship today, those who gathered all around the country, our community, to be with us today, for the spiritual gifts of all of our members, for those celebrating special events in their lives, especially Dorothy Swetham, Cooper Light, Nancy Stouffer, Elizabeth Anderson, Betty Dossie, Natasha Zobiski, that the Holy Spirit would guide them in their journey and work. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. So with bold confidence and in your love, in the love of Almighty God, we give all into your eternal care because we know that you listen to us, Lord. You told us in your word today. So we offer all these and those who've departed into your eternal care. The peace of Christ be with you always. Amen. We're going to take a moment and do something special. So I want you to follow along with me. Okay, everybody, come on. Okay. So we're out in front of my house here. There's this, there's a corner, and the neighbor likes to let this grow. And so I thought, this is kind of cool. Kind of reminds me of being at the Garden Tomb. So what a great place to say the Lord's Prayer. It's Passover, and I see some people walking by, some Jewish folks walking by, and I want to pray for our Jewish friends in our Passover celebration. I've got my mask, courtesy of Deborah Kalinoff. And so, outdoors, out in the garden by the tomb, mailman's across the street delivering the news, so I thought we would say the Lord's Prayer together. It's Easter morning, why not? Please join me with Christians all around the world as we say the Lord's Prayer, the prayer that belongs to the church, the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against one another. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. It's Easter. It's beautiful outside. So now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and grant you and your family his perfect peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Be blessed, brothers and sisters. I have a special surprise at the end of this, but right now, John's going to lead us in one more song because this is Amazing Grace. And after that, stay tuned because we're going to do something special. Be blessed.
Justice. shines like the sun in all of its brilliance. The King of glory, the King above all kings. This is amazing grace. This is unfailing love. That you would take my place. That you would bear my cross. You laid down your life that I would be set free. Oh, Jesus, I sing for all that you've done for me. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain.
So let us conclude as we always do. How awesome is this place? This is none other than the house of God, and this is, my friends, the gate of heaven. You know what? I'm feeling like I want the party to go on and continue. So what do you say? Everybody up. Everybody out of your seats. I'm feeling it. If you're feeling it. Okay, so let's, everybody up. So clap your hands. We're going to keep this party. We're going to keep this resurrection thing going here. Okay, all you, join it. And let's make it happen. Okay.